invitation, and I have to apologize. Say I no show on time. Comrade, I'm going to tell you, say, normally for events like this, I take time in quite seriously. But Fridays, I get a radio show. And my radio show also, now where I work for the people. The radio show is called The People's Perspective. And I start from 11 to 12, so I don't think make I'm here early at 10:30. I happy every time when Jav call for us to come together, the Joint Action Front. Now good umbrella body, we get a good network of bringing all of us. We want to liberate this country together. And I want to thank them for always playing their role. You know, the NLC and TUC grand protest, this is not the second time in 8 years. 8 years ago, we gathered like this. We gathered like this because they tried to oppress us, they tried to put their, you know, the usual thing we've been through, and we gathered like this. And for me, between 8 years ago and now, I believe, say, both NLC and TUC supposed to embrace their political destiny. The job of NLC and TUC is not to create strike and protest alone, but to create a platform to represent these people politically. There's a laziness in the leadership of this country in all sectors, not only in the government, but in our own side too. After the 2012 protest, I really don't feel comfortable with the end. I believe, say, after the protest, there was supposed to be something else. Something else for us as a people. You know, and when it did not happen, we had a movement that, we had a group that time, we don't disband now, called Change Movement of Nigeria. So we can't invite Peter Eli, who was the former president of TUC.
Peter Eli.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So we invited him as a speaker. So he came and he talked something where they're very profound. And another thing I hold for hand, where they come here today. Peter said, well, even if NLC and TUC talk, say they represent Nigerian people, in the actuality of it, they only represent 3% of Nigerian people. You see, and when they enter negotiations, as long as the 3% what they represent, they're comfortable with the price what they negotiate with federal government, they are justified to pull out of negotiation and strike. So, are you people going to pull out again this time when it justifies your 3% members? That's why I come here today. Maybe they protest again. I want political alternative for the people of this country. If NLC no one do them, then let's support DSM. If they don't disband them, let's fight for them to be put back together and let's go on that platform with NLC backing them. I no get time to protest. I'm sorry. Now where they read all NLC and TUC demands, they are pro-people demands. So how do you go from those demands to the demands that you end up with when you come out of negotiation after 1 week of protest with federal government? We will not be used again for NLC to negotiate for their 3% membership. NLC has to tell us today, and TUC, today, where they are ending where they are standing on. Are they representing their 3% in this protest or the people of Nigeria? That's why I'm here. Tell us what you want us to do. If at the end of it, you want us to support you, to use our energy to enter federal government negotiation, we will not accept. We will not accept. If you want to use our energy to enter negotiation with federal government only to live there for the benefit of your members only, we will not accept. I will stay in my house. Strike is already happening. We don't need to protest for strike. I don't need to come outside and waste my energy. When Jeff called all of us together, like-minded people in this country, all labor unions came. Comrade Aremu here, give everybody a task, simple task. Make everybody write simple reports and submit them back to Jeff in a week. Now this comrade, I don't forget, now be the coordinator. I said, now let me submit my report to him. Nobody did anything else. So that's why we are here again, 8 years. after 2012 to discuss this. We are in the same place we were 8 years ago. We are as powerless as we were under Jonathan, as we are under Buhari. How come? When we are the one that put Buhari there. Buhari rode into government due to the work that we did to create energy. Let's say ancestors don't come. This is the question of today. Ancestors don't come as school at all. Maybe when I believe in coincidence, say that science make rain they fall, now we are the doctor lie. Ancestors don't come ask school at the same question too. If maybe I don't come here anymore, I really wanted to be here as early as possible. But I had my further commitment for my own job. Because me, God, as a musician, I never worked since December last year because of Corona. It's true. So now I work in the radio station as a radio presenter. Before I joined 1 million boys. 8 years after 2012, I am disappointed at where we are politically. I am disappointed at our powerlessness as a people. I'm disappointed that we are still being acted upon by a few people in this country. Because why? Between the 8 years and now, between 2012 and now, the 8 years we don't pass, no political ambition from the NLC. No political ambition from the TUC. So the status quo continue. Until they want to use us again to negotiate with federal government. NLC must stand up to its tax. The labor unions of this country, like everywhere else, must realize that sometimes you cannot negotiate with the oppressor. Sometimes you have to remove him. And that's the situation we are in this country. How many times are we going to go through this before the NLC decides and the TUC to do away with their politically mandated differences by Obasanjo, because TUC and NLC don't get any difference. I don't know why we get the two of them. To fulfill their political destiny and represent the people of this country. Now my message here is that tonight I'm not getting into the country of Nigerian people. In fact, I don't understand the suffering that most people go through, because I don't go through it. So for me to even come and stand here, I'm not talking about suffering. In a way, it's hypocritical. If we want to talk about suffering, let's go and meet the people that are suffering to tell us what's going on. Yes, we are all enjoying to a certain extent. We are talking about our own job here, I believe, is to manifest our political destiny. NLC are going to negotiate with the federal government of Nigeria. NLC should be telling the federal government of Nigeria that they should be meeting them at the polls in 2023.
Thank you.
We are not meeting them in any boardroom. We are not meeting them in a secret where we don't know what to negotiate. Come and talk to the people. You are mobilizing the people already, but for what? So that some people can go and negotiate for 3% of Nigerians. Because that's what Peter told me. I'm not making it up. Because after 2012, I had to ask him what we are doing. I couldn't sleep. And he told me, I said, because the list of demands that the NSC and TUC stood on top of that protest and what they agreed on was so far apart. I had to ask, what happened? And he told me, in the meeting, it is the interest of their own members that they are there for. So why are you calling on all Nigerians? If when you enter closed door, you only discuss for your members. So don't call on us, because we are not your member, we are only your ally. So if you are not going to talk for me in that room, why are you calling for me here? The NLC and the TUC must promise the Nigerian people that they are on their side completely, 100%. This is what we need from them, and this is what must be guaranteed to us today. I'm happy that high-ranking members, maybe they left or they came, but you have influence. Tell them that we might not be as powerful, but the little people that we have influence over, before that 28 protest, if NLC and TUC do not give us guarantees other than lip service, we will not join them. Let them give you their 3% and negotiate for their 3%. Other than that, I don't see any reason why we should join them if they are not going to fight for us where it matters. I am tired of Nigerian people going through this hardship every time. Look at Kogi yesterday.
There was a tanker
explosion. Killed children. Nobody is held accountable. You understand? Now, private company too, tanker, kill people in Ishaga, in Uju. Nobody will be held responsible. There are people like me in Nigeria that can make them be responsible by making the matter an issue. They are called influencers. But these powerful people in Nigeria, they demand from you self-censorship before you get their sponsorship. I repeat, they demand, so they don't even have to call you to say, shut up. They demand that you yourself, by yourself, censor yourself. Then they give you sponsorship. So in that aspect, we can't be saved. Pipeline will blow up under the ground by federal government. Private tanker will blow on the ground by private individuals. Nigerians are dying. Do you understand what I'm saying? Tankers are exploding on the expressway. We have no choice but to politically represent ourselves. To come and tell us 8 years later that we want to go and negotiate again with federal government is an insult to the Nigerian people. The NLC and TUC must, once again, as I said, fulfill their political destiny. Enough of the laziness. Enough of the leg dragging. Enough of the leg dragging. Enough of the excuses just to use us to go and negotiate. Because I'm beginning to believe that people in NLC are corrupt. I don't want to believe it. I don't want to believe it. Because for me, as soon as I really, really believe that, then all hope is lost. I don't want to believe it. I want to believe that maybe they don't want to, they are not ready. But we want to tell them that they have to be ready now. We don't want negotiation in boardroom. We want to meet the federal government at the police station in this country, all over this country, for every single position. Come 2023. That is what we want from the NLC and TUC. This strike is great, but before me I will join you, NLC and TUC have to tell us, Nigerian people, that they are not going to betray us and only negotiate for their 3%. Thank you very much.